the walk, I would think the biggest thing is just kind of saying to her, like, the tempo, right? Like, that is, or I should say the rhythm of the walk, right? So that you want to do whatever walk you find the clearest rhythm when you're starting out. So, like, if you have to cover a little longer and a little quieter, like, longer, flatter kind of almost in the walk to get the clear rhythm, do that at the start for sure. And then I think once you have her a little bit more warmed up, then hopefully you can find it even in the collection. But I wouldn't start out, yeah, probably pressing at her too much. Even there, almost slow to the halt, and then walk out of it. Like, just kind of what you're doing there is saying, hey, do you half halt, right? Like, the same thing we were talking about in the trot and canter. Like, to me there, she's not really saying, whoa. Like, she sort of shortens and keeps going. So make sure, yeah, that you actually affect, though, the actual rhythm. Like, say to her, go slower there. And by that, I mean it should go through to the height. For you for not just bending her neck big time to the left, but think about I have to bend her body quite a bit more to the left, like bend her around her leg quite a bit more. Yeah, that she allows you with that left leg. And there you go, there was a step. Yeah, and then, yeah, exactly, that's why I said there was a step, because then she's like, hi. But you just have to go right back to that and say, that step is what I want clear down the long line. Change anything you're doing, I would just keep going with it until she kind of goes, I get this. That's better at the end. Yeah, good for you though. That's super on your part because you didn't change anything in the connect. You just said, you need to move off my left leg there, right? And there she finally did step through it better. But it was perfect when you didn't change anything in front, because if you were to change something in front there when you're discussing that with the left leg, it would have made it then no longer about the right reason, right? Like, the issue is the left leg, but she was trying to distract you with what she was doing in front. And you have to be like, no, I'm not taking part of that. You need to still move off this left leg. There you go. Great idea. Yep. Just keep with it. Like I said, it's hard in the walk because there's not that impulsion to cover stuff up.
Yeah.
But strides of trot forward just to say, hey, forward thinking. Trot, trot. Like, trot a few strides. Yeah. Forward. Hey, forward. That's not forward. Let's say to her, no, you go. Go for the bit. And walking again. And stays forward. Walk. that bend. There in a sense with your seat and leg, and just say you'll find it. Good. touch, like, just really focus on you're not going to the wall with your shoulder, and I'm bending you right. The rest of it, I think she's just going to level out there. Like, I would just push it forward and be like, that'll go well. Because that a little bit is her guessing, right? Like, if you push her a little bit more forward, that'll go away. There you go. Better shot. Step, step. Yeah. Good girl. Amazing, like when they're a little bit wanting to get negative there, right? A little quick caught under the collar. If you just talk to them a little bit, it helps enough even just be like, hey, yeah, it's close, just come on. I keep driving forward positive. That's it. Way better. But like here, the interesting part is, Eeva, you have way more of a half halt here, even though you're thinking of pushing her more, in a sense, forward. But it's connected, right? It's got a different look to it. Good right bend. There I would, with my right leg, I would just exactly give a little up, 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 okay, off of this. There you go. Right. You kind of broke apart the stiffness, right? Yeah, and do it again. Just say, no, no, up, up, come on, come in here. Oh, gosh. Correct. Good, Eeva. Yeah, yeah. Good. And then see if you can go a little bit again, like, in that shoulder four in the walk to the drop. And chuck in those 10 meters. Even start it on the 10 meter if that helps you, right? Forward. Sideways, Laura. Right, you're just thinking about those hind legs stepping right into the tracks of the foreleg when she reaches forward. She's not just swinging her butt out. Left hand a little lower to help her. Yeah, left hand down. Really drop your left hand a little there so you can help her to capture a little bit more on this outside edge. Here is a little bit of that running again, so just say to her, hey, find the half halt and find the actual bend through that right leg. Chuck in another 10 meter. My right leg. Yep, up to it, bending and up to it. Yep, stay another 10 meter. Yep, move, move, move. Right, just around, moving, and then again. Yep, drop the neck just a little there at the base of the neck, not the height of the pole. Saying to yourself there, I need to drop her a little at the base just so that she doesn't lock her back. There you go. That's it. You know what I mean by that? Like right in front of the wither a little so that she doesn't push her back tight against you. You need to just drop it so she brings her back a little up. That's better. Better steps. Right track. Keep going. Yeah, there. Find the half halt again. 10 meters. Already another 10 meter before she loses it, right? Like, that's it. Because then you breathe success into her, right? If you're saying to her there, yeah, yeah, I don't want you to feel like you lose it. I want you to feel like you can keep it, right? Thinking of the prep even for 10 meters because it helps you ride it just a little bit. You'd half halt if you were doing a 10 meter and you put your leg on a little more, right? So think, say, yeah. Yep. totally different truck she's